Pat, you may recall candidate Barack Obama said he would have the most transparent administration ever. But some critics say the White House is apparently doing more than any other administration ever to block the very transparency he promised. Paul Strand reports on a massive and disturbing crackdown.
Government watchdog Hans von Spakovsky says President Obama has signed bills to protect whistleblowers.
And yet the administration is doing everything it can, apparently, to retaliate against anyone who reports anything publicly or goes to Congress with evidence that the administration's done something wrong.
Eric Holder quit as Attorney General, but not before going after more whistleblowers than any of his predecessors.
How many whistleblowers? Well, of some 2,900 cases involving the government in the year 2013, almost half of them, 1,400, had something to do with retaliation against whistleblowers.
Eric Holder has opened up more leak investigations than all prior attorney generals combined. Which is really, that's quite something.
George Mason Law School's Richard Kelsey says we need whistleblowers more than ever in a time when the federal bureaucracy is growing so huge and out of control.
Whistleblowing is an essential piece now because the government has gotten so strong and so powerful.
The reason Congress has been passing more laws to protect whistleblowers is to try to limit the bureaucracy's inevitable efforts at self-preservation.
The first thing a bureaucracy does is it attempts to protect itself and grow its power. This is the problem with bureaucracies.
Even 47 of Obama's own 73 inspector generals wrote to Congress complaining about his administration's refusal to be transparent and open.
Refusing to turn over information and documentation that would enable them to do their jobs. That has never, ever happened before.
Most of these inspector generals are Obama's own appointees.
Who are supposed to be looking at abusive behavior, fraud, and yet they're the ones complaining about the administration not being transparent.
With this executive branch being accused by conservatives and even some liberals of overreaching for power, the danger of its actions to squash whistleblowers is apparent.
If you don't protect whistleblowers, then we don't know what's going on in these huge agencies that are creating regulations, that are enforcing these regulations against Americans, and that's why you have to protect whistleblowers.
One way the administration is shutting up potential whistleblowers is by using a legal loophole that lets it designate their work sensitive jobs, even if they really aren't.
Apparently, the government now is using that to designate all kinds of people who are supposedly sensitive so that they can't take advantage of the whistleblower protections, even though they really shouldn't have that designation.
And the administration also used one arcane law to sentence to prison the whistleblower who blew the lid off the CIA's use of waterboarding. So the first official to be convicted for waterboarding was, oddly enough, someone who never waterboarded anyone, but the guy who exposed it. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from the White House.